the new, well, for us in Australia, I guess, Helium HNtenna. I don't know if I can say it, keep it simple, keep it real, but this is just keeping it real. There's another antenna in stock with RF Shop. So I just quickly wanted to run you through this, tell everybody in the Helium or IoT space, 915 megahertz band, there's another antenna that you can now buy from RF Shop here in Australia. It's the HNtenna from MP Antennas. Now, of course, HNtenna, it is heavily focused around the Helium network, which is great, and that's currently the toggle to town, so to speak, but it's not just for Helium, it's for any IoT application, so anything that's 902 to 928 megahertz. Now, on their website, MP Antennas basically say it's US only, US Canada only, but that actually is because it's in the US market, it's being marketed in the US as a product. But for Australia, AU915, it is a excellent antenna and it works really well. It's also an antenna that works really well in the AS923 band, which is also in within that range of capabilities of this antenna. So if you use AS923, if you use AU915, if you've used US915, they all are 100% relevant for this model that we sell here in Australia. They do have a model for the European band as well, but because of the our Australian needs is for the AU915 or the US915 designed antennas. That's what we're going to look at here. Now, it's not an unboxing video. First of all, it's in a bag, and I hate unboxing videos because it's just kind of pointless. I just want to go through the features that's specific to this antenna. So let me just get it out of the bag, unbagging for what it's worth. You, of course, get the antenna itself. I'm now using this on my setup here in the workshop just because I really want to run through the paces and see what it's like, but I do like it. It comes with a right angle bracket, basically that antenna, and then the clamps. So what you get, I just can put this out of the way, is the antenna by itself. You can see it's actually not a huge thing. Ben from MP Antennas have opened it on camera in an interview with Nick from Crystal King. So you could see that it's kind of a bike cone type structure in there. Nice and compact, definitely waterproof, as you could see the from the top down. So there's no way that the water can get in. So it's a 3 dB gain antenna. Now this is almost a difficult one for me to talk through because low gain doesn't get as much attention and love as the high gain antennas in a lot of these communities. I do like low gain antennas a lot, and I like a classic antenna with a classic design such as this one a lot. The reason for that is that you get what you get. You know the radiation pattern is quite clean, it's quite predictable, and it's quite reliable. I, for one, get good range out of this antenna. And the other thing that's a bit of an opinion here, but it is a fact that with the narrow band application with IoT, you really work on narrow band applications. So your receivers, your miners on the other side of the scale, they actually are extremely sensitive. So when people are saying, oh, I need to get 10 kilometers, I need to get 20 kilometers, this type of antenna can hands down do that. Because of the signal strength by the time it hits the receiver is still well above what the capabilities is of those Helium hotspots or your typical IoT gateway. So 3 dB to me is a very handy number to use. So I would not dismiss this antenna in, well, first of all, in city applications, I'll get to that now, or even in more rural applications, such as we are here in Lonsdale in the south of Adelaide. It's kind of suburbia and it gets a little bit, not rural yet, but it's certainly on the outskirts. That's that, and the bracket that comes with it. One important thing to note, just as I have it upside down, is it actually comes with an N female connector. Now, in the Helium community, that might look like a challenge. As an antenna company and antenna engineer, this is, to me, normal, because vast majority of the antennas that we sell before we got into the Helium market was with N connector. So this is what you would mount, connect to, and then you would have an N connector coming out and you would a cable that is an N male. Why this is important for us and for anybody that sells cables is this antenna needs to get an N male connector on the cable, such as this one here. So there's an N male connector, which is different to what you would see if you just have this blanket Alibaba, or maybe in any of those cable types, you'll see they always have N female, because the antennas that you would get in the mainstream IoT, helium stuff seems to be in male. That's just something to be aware of. It actually has no impact on the antenna performance itself. In fact, this is to me normal from all the other antennas that we deal with. What else is there? They sell it as a multipolarized antenna. I don't know. I don't really want to try the American pronunciation for the multipolarization. It is something that gets sold as a useful artifact in cities and where you have a lot of reflections coming from buildings, so buildings or structures or trees or even hills and so forth. I agree, it is useful in the city. It is useful in places where you get a lot of reflections. But if I think just blanketly and clinically about what's happening in the IoT network, and I have this thing that I mentioned earlier. This is my little IoT sensor that we use. That is a small little antenna, really small, extremely small for the frequency it's operating in. If you say multipolarized, it means that the antenna is, in principle, capable of receiving any polarization that comes into it. Now, in the helium crypto and earning more rewards and so forth, you actually want me to talk to another gateway, or helium miner and get a better connection. But in reality, in the IoT network, we don't know what the orientation of these devices are going to be, because somebody might put it against the wall, somebody might put it on the ceiling, somebody might have it where it just keeps moving as you go around. So the polarization of your devices is kind of really undefined. It's just all over the place. So having a multipolarized antenna in your gateway and putting that to communicate with the IoT devices is, I'm used to it. It actually makes just perfect sense. And if you would think, yeah, but can't we control this? Just think about your cell phone. You place it anywhere, you place it any orientation, and you might just get it to work any different way. So to me, multipolarization, whatever, is really sensible. Not just for a helium network set up in a city where there's a lot of polar reflections, but just in general for the IoT application that we're looking at. That's it. It's on our website, rfshop.com.au. If you have any questions and what cable requirements you have, we can do custom cable links for you for this antenna or for any of the other antennas that we have on our website or just your application as well. Please remember to subscribe to our channel. If you have any comments, let us know underneath. We'll try to address them as soon as we can. Thanks for watching. See you on the next video. Bye-bye.